Hi, this is Reverend Robert Jones welcoming you to another edition of Blues Chronicles. Today we meet an incredibly innovative guitarist and one of the co-fathers of jazz guitar, Lonnie Johnson. Alonzo Lonnie Johnson was born February 8, 1899 in New Orleans, Louisiana. Born into a family of musicians, he could play piano, violin, and guitar, but concentrated primarily on guitar for his profession. Based in New Orleans, Johnson worked primarily in jazz. In 1917, Johnson joined a tour that took him to England. But in the current age of COVID, it's interesting to note that when Johnson returned home in 1919, he discovered that everyone in his family, with the exception of his brother, James Steady Roll Johnson, had died in the 1918 Spanish influenza epidemic. In 1925, Johnson won a blues contest, the prize being a recording contract with OK Records. This tagged him forever as a blues artist. Well, the way the sea is tossing this ship, we'll never see
land no more. People is raving about hard times. Tell me what it's all about. People is hollering about hard times. Tell me what it's all about. Hard times don't worry me. I was broke when it first started out.
Of course, Johnson's mastery of guitar was not confined to blues. In the 20s, he played with the likes of Louis Armstrong and his Hot Five, Duke Ellington, and McKinney's Cotton Pickers. He also toured with the legendary Bessie Smith. But in 1929, he recorded with Italian-American musician Eddie Lang, and together they created the vocabulary of jazz on guitar. In this pairing, Lang did most of the courting, while Johnson concentrated on elaborate, beautiful single-string runs. These recordings were among the first to feature black and white musicians playing together. To disguise this fact, Lang recorded under the name Blind Willie Dunn. In his later years, Lonnie Johnson worked both in and out of music, sometimes as a guitarist and sometimes as a janitor. In 1952, Johnson toured in England, where he met a skiffle artist named Tony Donegan. Johnson so impressed the Englishman that he changed his own first name to Lonnie. This clip shows Lonnie Johnson in 1961 as a part of the American Folk Blues Festival tour in Denmark. It's clear in this intro that Lonnie Johnson's music was a major influence on both T-Bone Walker and B.B. King. 1965, Johnson relocated to Toronto, Canada, where in 1969 he was hit by a car and died a year later after suffering a stroke. Lonnie Johnson remains a giant in both the world of blues and jazz. Well, another night you cry. For Blues Chronicles, this is Reverend Robert Jones. Baby, just cry.